So hello everyone, thanks for joining the webinar. This is Sonal Arora from Aventis. And as you know that we are here to talk about our new utility, that is practice management module, which will prescribe your basic utilities like invoicing, timesheet, and your employees' expenses management through the system itself. And you call it sometimes like an office management utility or a practice management utility. And this module is basically for CA professionals for their own internal use. They can use for their customers, like if they raise the invoices for their customers and everybody. So they can do the same office management or everything, this activities through the system itself. So now I'm proceeding towards product features. Before going to product features, I'll explain once again. For the start of the 15 minutes, we will explain the intro option about product and demo of the product. After that, in the last 10 minutes, we will have a QA session where you ask the queries if you misunderstood anything or not clear about anything. So let's proceed further. Here, this is the product features. So first, we will have a service master where we create the various services which are offered to your customers. For example, GST audit, GST return, TDS return, income tax return, stat audit, internal audit, and other services which you provide to the customers. So we have the service master already. There are some 5 to 10 default services already into the system. But if you want to addition some services which is not in the system, you can create by yourself. So there's no worry that you have to come back to us. You can create by yourself. Second, this is a major important feature of this product, that is customer-wise invoice schedule. So while you are adding the service at the first place, you give the schedule that, for example, if the service is annually, for example, your stat audit. So you will say that this bill will be raised on this 1st of April or whatever the expected date. And on the second, this is a schedule where you tag your customer with your service. For example, AL Private Limited, you assign your stat audit to this particular customer, then you will have a at the service fees structure over there and the frequency of the service. Moreover, you can add the GST will be inclusive in that service fees or exclusive. And if you want to have out-of-pocket expenses, means if your executive or you or your part of team member, anybody is going for an audit and they have incurred any expenses for the particular audit, then they can record that expenses. So you can have the particular OP expenses structure in advance, that it will be inclusive in your fees or it will be actual. And if it will be actual, if it is, will be limited, for example, up to 5,000, up to 10,000 in this way. So create customer wise and service wise fee structure and generate the invoicing scheduler also. Means if you have started giving services to this particular customer from 1st of February, so you can mention that we have started this customer, this service on this frequency from this date. And after proceeding giving the small masters, we will have an invoice generation. So before proceeding to invoice generation, we have a facilitated creation of invoice template, as everybody has different templates. So we have given the template. You can change some particular description, for example, professional fee, or you want to add some more details in your template, or you want to edit or delete any template. Customized template, you can have that. And after that, you can have an ongoing customer invoices through the system itself. After you have a invoicing generation and everything in the system, you can email your invoices to the customer through the system itself. You don't have to go to your email box once again and attach it. So you can do that from sisters itself. And you can track also that if your invoicing has been done but it has not been emailed, so you can track that this is not an email, it is pending for to be emailed, so nothing will get missed it out. And moreover, after that, there's an employee expenses. So employee expenses means employees can update all the expenses for each customer or otherwise, whether it is a recoverable or non-recoverable, and along with an approval workflow. If your executive or if your junior article has been added some expenses and it really, you are feeling not suitable, this expense is not suitable, so you can disagree with that expense also and it will not be reimbursed to him. After that, after your approval as a manager, then finance executive will approve it as a to reimburse the same way or not. After that, if your expenses are recoverable expenses, then same will be automatically charged to particular invoice, because when you record the expenses, then you mark that this expense to particular customer for this particular service, and automatically this expense will be captured in your invoice so that your expenses will not be missed at all. And moreover, after that, there is an employee timesheet. If you want to have a track that which team member have involved in which particular customer or service order, if you can have a activity-wise, means service can break down into activities. For example, if there's a TDS return, so you want to have bar verification is like a TDS working and TDS return and filing in two sections. So you can divide it on the activity basis. There will be in system, which showcase in the demo. And in that, you can have in the timesheet that this employee or this executive is involved this type of duration, 4 to 5 hours, to particular this customer and this service, and you can generate the report so that you have a full track of your team that and which customer taking how much time, so you have a full track through the system itself. Now we will proceed towards the product demo, which is the utility we want to describe, and you will get the access to the particular utility. So as you can see, here you can see the dashboard. This is a dashboard of a partner, where you can see have a track of full customer invoice value and in month-to-month invoice value. Currently, it is same because we have recorded only February expense for this demo purpose. Otherwise, if you have a January, October, or previous current financial year month, then this value will be more than this value. And overdue invoices, so means your schedule has to be take place, but your billing has not been done. So you can track this is an overdue invoicing. This needs to be done. And these are the expenses, means your invoice has been already done through system, but your executive or your any team member have been recorded the expense after the generation of invoice. So you can manually generate the invoice for particular this unrecovered expense. You can have a chart for service-wise, which is unbilled and billed. So overdue, this overdue and invoiced value will be matched with this, that billed or non-billed service-wise. So which is unbilled and billed, you can track to system that this is unbilled value for this particular service. And whatever is billed, it will be further written in details over that which financial year, which period, what is the service fee, what are the service, and which legal entity under a customer, if the customer is a very big group. And the pending recovery details also available here, that which invoices has been already billed and emailed to your clients, but your recover this expenses has been recorded late. This is a full intro about the dashboards. Now we move towards how these values have been come over here and what are the masters and everything. So first we move to the form. So we will create a form on behalf of you, but you have to edit this form. For example, this is your form name. You have to add the GST if GST is applicable to your CA form, your address or PAN. And after saving the details, because if you don't save it, then GST will not be available in your invoice. And after that, if you have a different office location, you can add from there also. And you can add from here also. And after that, there will be a users. Users have a four roles in the practice management modules. Like here, there are four roles: executive, finance executive, manager, and partner. These are the basic details: email ID, first name, last name. Hope this is not a problem. But this role I want to explain. Partner has a full access and full rights of everything. Manager and executive have right only to the particular customer, which will be mapped to them. We will map the customer in the setup section. We will showcase in some time. And finance executive will be one CA firm, only have a one finance executive who will have a second layer of review of expenses and the reimbursement of expenses. This is your concerned finance person in your CA firm. Executive have a very limited rights that to record a timesheet or expense statement. And managers have some particular rights to add this invoicing and everything, view the invoicing, and based on the page authorization. We'll also see, showcase you the what is the page authorization here. But these are the basic rules in this practice management module. So once you have your form details, GST, and your users, means your team members are ready into the system, then we will move towards another master, which is the service. So we have some basic service already into the system, and another services you can add by your here also. You can select the SAT call, and you can name the service, and what is the frequency of service will be there, and accordingly your billing schedule will be visible. For example, in GST audit annually, this is from 1st of April, your bill should will be scheduled. So this billing will not be done. Billing will be done manually through system itself, but it will showcase if it is you have not raised the bill on the 1st April, it will showcase that it is an overdue. You have a full track of invoicing through the system itself. In the same way, if you want to edit, you can edit also. You want to rename it, you want to change the frequency, you can do it. After that services, we have activity. This activity is basically for the expenses and your time sheet. When your employees add their expenses and time sheet, that your one service means divided into three or four sections. For example, TDS returns and TDS working, GST audits or GST reconciliations. You can add just name over activity here and save it. It is very easy, master. After that, we have already discussed form initially. We have very important, that is a setup. As some of your CA firms already have access to audit, labor, or secretarial product utility, so whatever customers you have created in there, it will automatically reflect here. Still, if you want to add a customers or their group, if it is a very big group and there's a legal entity, you can add to system itself. And you don't have to go once again to every page, just here only add the customer, their legal entity, add the GST details, for example. Add and get the details. It automatically will get popped up, your GST details. You just have to add TAM and necessary details. Your email for invoicing, means whom this first entity's email should go to if Aventis invoice you are raising for this customer, then who will get the invoice, the email for the invoice sharing, and make sure your status will be active. And we have, if in this demo purpose, we have only one product, but if you have a multiple product access and you have applied for multiple products, so you can create this one customer to multiple products by one click only. Also, if you are creating an entity, your customer is already created, but your entities has not been created, or entities is created in a less number. So you just select your customer, add the GST details for entity, and add the entity. But if you want to create a customer or entity in one go only, so you can click here and also create here. So once we have this customer entity, then we will move towards tax details. So whatever the tax details you have mentioned here, TAN, GST, and if it is TAN also, it will automatically available here in the tax details, for example, in Aventis. But if you want to add the details, you can also add the details under this customer. What is tax type, what is GST, your user ID or password, the government link, you can have at one place only. After that, we will proceed towards our user customer assignment. The thing we are, I have told you that partner have a full access, but manager and executive only have the access which are the customer has been mapped or assigned to them. For example, if I'll add new and I add this, Aventis will be assigned to Monica Patel and to this Anushka. So only this two executive, this executive and this manager has seen only this customers or assigned customer, not all of the customers. On the basis of that, we will proceed for the customer service setting, which we have told about the customer service scheduler also. For example, here we can add here the customers, click the customer and entity. You can add as many rows as up to 5 here. You can add, but if you want to add any additional service, you can go back to the screen and add new once again. But you can add to 5. I just add once again. I need to add only one for two demo first. So if you are giving service to Eventis or Eventis this legal entity on this particular date from 1st of February 20, let's say May 20, you can add what type of service you are giving. For example, GST audit, what is the period billing frequency, one time or annually. It is annually, what is the fee? So let's say 50,000 rupees. If GST is inclusive or exclusive. So you have added service fee, this is per year, so you can have exclusive or inclusive. So whenever the invoice will be generated annually for this, GST will be calculated that it's already included in this fee. If it is exclusive, then it will be more above this 18%. So let's say I'll add exclusive. Now, if your expenses incurred for this particular audit, so you can want to add that, okay, 50,000 includes the expenses also. That is OP means out-of-pocket expenses, which is over and above from this piece. So it will be an exclusive at actual but limited or actual. If it is already inclusive in this particular piece, then it will be an inclusive. So what is the meaning for actual but limited? That you have at actual but in a limited case, that up to 5,000 only or up to 10,000 only. So you can add a limit also. But if you don't want to add a limit, actual will be charged, so you can tag that. For example, I'm now tagging it actual. This record has been saved. Let's see, Eventis. So it's been already saved here. And from 1st of May, this service has been provided or started to Eventis for GST audit already. So now we have created almost the necessary masters. This is an invoice template. This is the mail body. Email body will send to and page authorization. I will proceed further to invoice template. So there are the two templates, with or without annexure. What is its meaning? If your expenses tagged or recoverable charge to particular invoice, then it will be with annexure. But if your expenses not include a particular invoice, then it will be without annexure. So automatically system will take that you have to take with or without, but templates should be into the system. So let's say if I'll go to the with annexure, this is the template. So in this bracket area, you cannot change it because it's the values. System will take over automatically the invoice date, invoice number, customer name, customer address, PAN number, GST automatically will taken from the system itself. You can change this language and you can change, you can add your bank detail. You can also add, if you want to add a further details or somewhere around one or two more lines extra in your invoice system, particular edition. And after that, you can see this is an annexure, details of out-of-pocket expenses. So details will be automatically get tagged out. I'll open the without annexure once again. There's nothing, this same annexure details will not be here. Will be same. Now we move towards another master, which is body template. Body template is not other than an email body, which will go to your customers while sending the email invoices through the system. For example, I'm just adding this for a testing purpose. For example, greetings from my mentors or greetings from CA form, whatever your CA form you can add here for demo purpose. And this is the language we use. So you want to have like automatically from Sonal Arora, or only want to add Sonal Arora in your name and contact number, you can add that also. And you can update it. This is an email body. This is a one-time master facility. You don't have to do once again and again. Now we move to the last master, that is a page authorization master. So page authorization includes, you want to give access to particular managers or finance executives for activities, to add the activity, update or delete or view, or to add or update or view services. And if you want to give the generate view access also. So So sometimes this finance executive have already access of view for everything. If you want to give additional access as a partner of the CA firm, you don't have enough time, you just give access to a particular finance executive or manager. You can just select the drop down and give the access accordingly. Now we move towards the report generation. Before going to the report generation, don't worry about it. There's a complete user manual into the system already here, where your all the masters I have explained over here only in this help section. So you can go through one by one, and we will also provide you the recording of the session. Now we move towards invoice generation. So as you can see in this screen, there is a customer entity, service names, whatever the service is, period, billed, unbilled, upcoming. I'll go to 1920. There's something overdue also. This red color way shows that your email status, the email has not been drawn. So this green status will show that email status is done. So you can have a track that email has been gone or not. So if it is billed but email has not been gone, it will be a red color. And this check boxes will show that you have to add the invoices. Invoices has not been done, so there's no color. If it is billed, only then colors will be there. But red will be when the email has been sent to your particular customer, invoice has been sent to system. But if invoice has not been sent, then it will be red color. And if email sent, then it is a green color. Let's say in 1920, there are two check boxes that you want to have overdue of this expense. You just click on this particular check box, add the invoice. For the first time as a CA firm, you add your invoice number, so afterwards it will take like for example now it is 9, but it automatically takes because we have already added invoices. But in the first time, if you are doing a manual invoicing, you can add first time what is your last invoice number or what is the current invoice number. Afterwards it automatically takes. But if it is a new financial year, then it will automatically takes 1 as an invoice number. But the invoice format you can describe, it will be take it as it is. I'll save this invoice and it will be available to download. So you can see here there's a complete date of invoicing, billing, bill number, your details, PAN, GST, concerned person name, project internal audit, your service fees you have must be added over there. And what is your fees for particular service? For example, internal audit, what is the period of audit? And what is the SAT code? And the GST, whatever it is applicable. Because I have not added bank details in my invoice template, that's why it's completing, giving cross. So if you give whatever in your invoice template, you want to add bank details only one time. And this is my demo CA firm name. So this is coming over here only. I'll showcase you one annexure one also, just for your reference. So here you can see that out-of-pocket expenses has been added here, and this is an annexure. So these are the expenses have been added by this. These are the expenses details. These are the amount. And if this, for example, your expense limited is up to 30,000 for this particular service. So automatically it will show 42,700, but it shows that invoice will be considered as a 30,000 and invoice value will be here as a 30,000 in that case. So it will go to red color one where you can see available the invoices. You can download here the invoice with a Word copy. You can digitally sign it or you can physically sign it and scan it. And you can upload the signed copy here. And once you upload, you can email send. This email body automatically gets copied. But if you want to change for this particular email, you can change it and send it to the system itself. So here, invoicing will be very easy. There will be very easy tracking. Nothing will get missed out because if something gets missed out, it will automatically pop up over the dashboard. This is the overdue expenses and overdue invoices, and this is unrecovered expenses which has not been taken care in your invoice. So we have covered full masters and invoicing. Now I move towards another utility, that is timesheet. So same access has been given to your executives also, this timesheet, that they will select a particular range of dates, for example. Let's say that 1st January to 31st January, 11th January. I'll click add. So you can select here, there's a details of till 10th January will be over here. In page 2, there will be 11th January because 10 details in one page. You can select on which customer you are working on this 1st of January and what is your legal entity you are working on, what is the service you were going to provide in this particular, and activity, this is the subsection of this particular service. You can use it like that, and what is the duration you are giving it. For example, 7 hours. And if you want to add a description also, you can add the description also and save it. So I'll showcase you where I have already added. For example, here in the 9th list, I have already added selected customers, entities, your services, your activities, and your durations, and the description, and the save it. So same will be available as a report to your managers and partners. It's a very easy utility, and here you can track that which team member is working on which and how much duration they are working on that particular service or particular customer's entity. Now we move towards expense statement. After this demo, I'll also explain where the thing is available in your user manual or this help section. Here, you can see in a view access of an expense management, whatever you have added as an executive or whatever the partner or manager, if you have incurred any expenses, if it is recoverable, you choose yes. If it is not recoverable, you choose no. I'll say it is a recoverable and select it has been expense incurred on Aventus for Aventus Electric Private Limited and for GST audit for a particular financial year 1920. Actually, I have not started this service in 1920. Earlier, I have started in 2021. So I forgot it is in 2021. So if you want to add a particular manager over here, you can add a manager also. You can add a narration also. What is the date of expense when you incurred the expenses? What is the expense type? For example, flight. If it is any proof of expenses, you can add a proof over here also. I'm just adding one dummy file. You can add whatever the file you want to add. And the remarks. If you have additional expenses also, you can add meal expenses, accommodation expenses. So basic expenses are here on the system. But if you have another, you can select others also. And whatever your expenses, you can have that also. So if you have not proof, you can give that this bill is not available. You can add, you can give this for the approval to, I'm just selecting the same person because I'm logged in as a partner. So user expenses has been added successfully and the same will be available here in the event list 12,500 and it is under pending for approval. So for your demo purpose, I have logged the expenses from Neha to Neha because this Neha is the partner over here now. So partner have the full access. But if your executive is adding, they will select your particular manager or partner only. So they are here in this reporting manager, only partners are based on the first one. Your partners or managers only available over here. Managers will be, if customer has been mapped to particular manager, but this partner have a full access to managers, partner always available. Just demo purpose, I have added the expenses to partner for partner only. So there's an approval concept. You can see it's here pending for approval, where you can approve, agreed, you can give the comments, approve this document, whatever they have attached, it will be available here. Not agreed or you want to reject, you can reject it also. See, it is approved. So once your expenses have been approved and then everything, it will go to finance executive for their further approval and reimbursement. Now we move towards the reporting section, where you can generate the report for your timesheet and expense sheet. So whatever the details available here, it will be same exported to Excel through this Excel button. If you want to be a only particular GL Private Limited export, you can export that. For now, I have exported all. It will be available here. When you generate the invoice, what is the date? And who has been spent, all the employee details, you can filter also, and you can after filter also export, and you can filter in your Excel. It's up to you. What is the service, what is the activity and description they have added, whatever the durations they have provided. So you have in one Excel full data of all for month or something. Start and ended also, if you want to have a timesheet, a particular range of data, range of date, then you can have set the range of debt and can export it to Excel. And in the same manner, you can export it to your expense management, expense report also. So here you can see there's a transaction serial number, it is recorded here, that's why it's coming here, it is on the back end, it is available, and the date of expense, who has added, your employee or user executive, and who is the manager, have approved it, it is recoverable or non-recoverable, what is the total expense, what is the approved expense, and what is the status, it is paid, pending for approval, approved by manager, but it is not pending. Approved by finance executive, which means that if it is rejected, then it will be rejected. If it is also approved by finance, then approved by finance also. So accordingly, you have a full track in the Excel also. If you want to have a particular range that from this to that, I want to have an expense report as a partner. You don't have enough time, you want to export to the system. I'll just give a quick crux once again. In the dashboard, there are the customers and full invoice value YTD. And if you have a YTD for current previous financial year, all means all previous years and everything. It means current and last previous year YTD. And it means current financial year YTD. So currently, we have only Feb data. That's why this invoice value YTD and month is same. But if you have a January or I can say November data also, for example, if you will raise the invoices in March also, then your invoice YTD will be greater than invoice value of the month. Overdue invoices means your schedule has been created into the system. The schedule get there, and but you have not raised your invoices. It is under overdue. And it is unrecovered expenses means you have raised the invoices, but your team member or you by yourself, if you have gone to the particular customer audit or something, you have expenses, but you have recorded the expenses late into the system, then it will be unrecovered, where you can generate the invoices later on. This is the month on month trend will be visible here in the February month or something. All the details of February month invoicing will be available. This is can be also exported to Excel. There's a customers or start date or financially, you can export it to Excel after checking it. And after that, there's a service wise invoice status. If you want to see that what is the revenue for company audit, what is the GST audit revenue. So if you want to track it, you can track it also. What is the billed and unbilled value, but it will be a full will be visible here. And there is also what is the invoicing you have done, it will be available here in current financial year. And you can show all also. Same will be can export it to Excel with the date of change also. And financial year, for example, if it was the current financial year you moved into, you want to change the financial, you can change from here. And you can export it to Excel for your reference. Now on other page we have it is a pending recovery. So in the upper scale you can only see the value, but in the larger, in the below scale you can see the details of invoicing which is overdue or pending to be recovered, and details will be available here. You can export it to Excel and circulate to your team that why it is unrecovered, or you want to have a manual invoicing for that. So this is the dashboard available. Quick circuit once my masters, we have a service where you can add the services, basic services already into the system, like company audit, GST audit, TDS returns, income tax returns already into the system. But if you want to have an additional services like due diligence and extra, you can add. Activity is a subsection of our services which is available for your timesheet section and expense section, where your executives or your junior articles will record the timesheet on the activity basis and duration that on this particular service for this particular customer under this activity, like TDS working, TDS return, income tax computation, income tax return, and if there's income tax representation, due diligence, they can add the activities accordingly. And the duration they will be taken care on the particular activity. You have a full track that which employees is working on this particular activity or a service for this particular duration. And in this form, you have to add, you can add your particular GST address and your form details, CA form details. And you can also edit your form team members or users. As you know that in ICI, as per ICI MOU, we have already the limit of 5 users up to here. You can create the in a free version only 5 users, but if you want to exceed the limit, you can contact to us through this phone number and email ID over here, and we can give you the quotations for the paid version. After that form, there's a setup, and setup is the customer entity. If your customer, if you have for the registration for other products like audit, secretarial, labor, and our practice module also. Then you, if you have already created the customers or entity in the particular module already, and you just have to tag it, it will be always available in the practice module. But if you are adding a new customer which is not in your audit or another software, you can add here also. Under these customers, you can create the customer or a group. And if under a customer, there are many legal entities which already created your customer, you can select the customer from drop down and add the legal entity. So I am going fast because I am repeating the flow that I have already explained, so that if something missed out or something has not been disturbance is there, you can see that. So whatever the text details you have added while adding this legal entity or customer over here, the same will be available in the text details section. If you want to add the text details section, that is completely optional. If you don't want to add into the system, please don't add. But if you want to add and you don't want to manage your Excel sheet or something, you just have here select the customer, their text, for example, EPF number, EPF login, everything will be there. So whenever you just log in, you have to log in through Eventis, copy paste this link, add your user ID and password, you go and log in. After that, we have a user customer assignment. This is applicable only for executives or managers. So executive is the junior level person, that is articles or your who is going to audit for where they don't have access to particular this utilities of masters or invoicing. They only have this ex utility that is timesheet expense management. So this, whoever the part, customer you have assigned to particular executive, it will be visible and they can add the timesheet for expense sheet for this particular customers only. And managers is the higher level authority to this manager, but managers have only access to particular these utility invoicing or staff reporting only for this particular customers which you have assigned here. Here the customer service, this is the most important master. I will explain this little bit slow. Here you can select a particular customer, legal entity, and when you are giving this legal entity or customer a particular service, what is your start date? Example, from first of January, I'm giving the starting service. What service you're going to see? This is the tagging of customer service and the date frequency means date of start. What is service fees you are charging? GST is inclusive or exclusive. Expenses up to which date? I think GST return won't have any expenses till I add. Then add right here. The records will be saved. So what are you doing here? You are creating customer service billing scheduler. You are doing here means under a particular customer, there's a legal entity. You are tagging the service here, their frequency, adding a fee structure and frequency, and how will be your billing? GST inclusive or exclusive, or OP out of pocket will be inclusive or exclusive. For example, if you're not going to charge OP extra, then you can select OP inclusive over here. So this is the customer service. And after that, there's a basic masters. This is a self-explanatory templates or body templates. So I move towards invoicing once again. So if your bill is already done, but email has not been sent, it will be in red color. If bill already billed and email also sent, then it will be in green color. If it is upcoming bill, it will show as the upcoming bill, but it has not been billed. So there's a checkbox and also there will be no color. But if you have an overdue billing, it will show as an overdue here. You can click on this checkbox and add the invoice. Further, if you want to add a timesheet or your employees want to add a timesheet, they can select a range and click on the add button. They can add a timesheet under which customer, for which entity, for which service, and which activity you're doing, how many hours you're doing work for the particular activity. It will be available here. If your team member has been explaining the expense statement, you can add here. Select a recoverable. It should be charged to particular invoice, under an invoice for a particular customer. Select a customer, and for that customer, whatever your managers or partners will be available here. For which service you are adding this expenses, for which financial year, you can select over there, and accordingly you can add the which expense type and what is the date of. And if it is approved, you can attach. And after your attaching and approval, your manager will approve your expenses. And after their approval, they can approve here, approve or reject. And after their approval, finance executive will approve it. And after that, you can generate the timesheet or expense sheet reports also. So in ex if your ex recorded expenses is recoverable, then whether it is approved or not, currently they can be charged to invoice. They are not waiting for your approval. So approval concept is basically for the reimbursement, whether they have currently approved or not something, but invoice, under an invoice, that expenses will automatically be charged even if they are not approved. This is the currently system will work. For the last 5 minutes, we have already reached to 4:44. I will explain the help document just a minute. Then we will have a QA session. How this help document will be useful for you, I am explaining so that you can use this product very effectively. There's a table of contents that how you log in. Most of the CA firms already using the our audit and everything, so log in the same way. If you are first time logging in, so you can log in to this particular link. You have already received the password from alert@advertis.co.in. You can log in from that. Then it will automatically redirect you to change your password, temporary password. Then again you will log in with your registered ID and email password. There will be dual authentication. If you are not receiving OTP or you don't want to keep the OTP authentication, you can set your secret questions and answers here. And after then you will log in into the system. And these are the basic active modules we have already provided: audit management, secretarial, labor compliance, or practice management. If you have forgotten your password, you can click on the forget and change your password. Your account has been locked in the same way. If you add the password 3 times wrong, or if there's a caps lock key on or something, then you can click on the account lock section. It will get your email ID and give you the temporary password. You can log in it and can change the password. So this is the basic utilities I'm explaining, because sometimes we have received the queries that they are not able to log in or successfully not receiving that. So in the masters, what I have explained to you, it's one by one available here: service master, activity, form users creation, customer legal entity, user customer assignment, customer service mapping, which we can say customer service scheduler also. Excuse me. Invoice template, body template, page authorization. Service master already explained, it's available here. So you don't have to go one by one. So whatever you want to see, just click on the link and you will reach over there. So after masters, we have timesheet, how to add a timesheet and everything. So you can go over here by scrolling also, and you can go over here from this link also. 39. You can reach to timesheet. You want to see how to add a timesheet. This is an expense management, add the expenses, approval and rejection of expenses. That if you want to have an invoicing, you can add how to do an invoicing and everything. 90% things are covered in user manual. Still, if you're not able to understand anything, please feel free to reach to us. This is also an email ID given here also in the practice user manual, and also has been provided here the email ID and phone numbers you can reach to us. In the last 10 minutes, we will have a QA session. I will stop sharing my screen.